stars. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
The biggest names in music.
Oh, wow.
Big names. Big songs. Big guests. Big prizes.
Well, it's a big show.
Okay. The Big Show.
Put your hands together for the one and only
Glenn, Angel, FD, and Sean.
That's what I'm talking about.
1FM 91.3. Good times, greatest hits. 1, 2, 3.
Good morning, Singapore. Good morning, world. Welcome to The Big Show. It's Glenn, Angel, FD, and Sean. And our guest for this morning is Mr. Arthur Kiong, CEO of Far East Hospitality. Good morning, Arthur.
Hi, good morning, everyone.
Oh, so nice to hear that voice again, Arthur. It's been so many years.
Hello, good morning, everyone.
Now, Arthur was a radio DJ back in the 1980s, okay? Part of SBC. Do you still remember what SBC stands for?
Sipe Chum.
Arthur Kiong, everybody!
So tell us, Arthur, when you started out in radio in the 80s, as Glenn mentioned, what was the radio station you started out with?
At that time, there was only two English channels, and 90.5 FM was Radio 1. And 95 was actually the classical radio station. So that's the reason why they call it, I thought, Class 95. But Class 95 was just because it's classics
there
95,
you go,
where you pay Beethoven and Mozart, and so you put a record and then you go to the bathroom for half an hour and come back and drink and flip the other side.
Wow.
But I wasn't qualified to be on Class 95 because I can't pronounce Mozart. So I was on the pop station, which was Radio 1. So at that time,
wow,
it was very exciting. Radio 1, I remembered when Radio 1 went 24 hours and they had a morning show just like the one that you're doing now. Mm-hmm. And for all the years that I've been on radio, I've never been scheduled the morning shifts, because the morning shifts are for the prime jocks, the really good ones. And, and so it's a privilege to be amongst you celebrities this morning. So thank you.
Wow. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Arthur, for joining us. I mean, you're a very busy man these days. We'll be talking a little bit more about the exciting things that's happening at Far East Hospitality. But I think for the benefit of everyone who is watching right now, who still remembers Arthur Kiong, the radio DJ, who was on air for, 2 years or so, who did the morning show while you were on Radio 1 back then? Was it Tony Orchez?
No, I think Tony Orchez came much later. It was a gentleman by the name of Ian Disdain. So we used to call him Ian Disdain, but his name is Ian Disdain. And he obviously was someone who hailed from the BBC. So we were very excited to have a BBC voice to do that morning show. And then subsequently, the morning jocks were the more experienced ones, JJ and Susan Ng.
Jeanette Joseph.
And Lynette, at that time was...
Lynette Pang?
Lynette was Sadong.
Lin Sadong.
Before she became Sadong.
So
that was how long it goes. So for those people who remember these things that we're talking about on the air, they're probably all wearing hearing aids. So it's a long time ago. It's a very long time ago.
It is.
So tell us a little bit, I mean, because I was never obviously a jock in the 80s, and it's always so fun to find out how things have changed. You guys did records.
Yes,
right,
records.
Back then. And how did you plan your shift, and how did it work? Did you were you guys more on air or more music?
Well, we were. We had to script our records, and there was a policy on scripting records. It's male singer, female singer, instrumental.
Okay.
And it doesn't matter whether it's country music, with rock, with pop, but it is male, female, and then an instrumental. And a lot of records at that time was banned because, you know, at that time the station was a lot more conservative. Was a lot more conservative, and everything was controversial, including instrumentals. I remember wanting to play instrumental to start my show, and they have a big whiteout mark X because that track was banned.
Wow.
So I said the title of the song is White Rabbit, why would white rabbit be offensive? Yeah. I don't know, maybe it has got to do with the policeman on motorcycle.
Oh, so, Lord.
I said, you think a white rabbit refers to a traffic policeman? He says, yeah, we don't know, but let's ban it anyway. Just to be safe.
Just in case, wow.
Oh, man.
You know, there was a lot of self-censorship. Let's face it.
Yes, there was.
You know, there's always a body, right? Yeah. Back then, I don't think it was called MDA.
That is absolutely not true, Glenn.
What's not true?
It's not self-censorship. I got called up for almost, you know, the phone would ring for every three sentences I said on the air. So it wasn't self-censorship. I was being muzzled. I remember one day I said something like, this track is going out for all of you on the roads right now. And then the phone rang.
Why?
The phone rang. And the lady on the end of the line says, well, Arthur, I understand that you want to be hip, but we have to remember there are a lot of people who are listening to you from elsewhere apart from their cars.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right.
So let's just keep the rhetoric simple. Just say the name of the song, tell them the time, and announce the record, tell them the time, and that's all you do. You know, let's not add too much commentary into in case anyone gets offended. So those were very different days, right, where everything can be it was, and people do listen, you know, and make sure that nothing is untoward is being said. So at that time, to be a DJ, say as little as possible. That's the rule.
Wow. Interesting.
We are speaking to Arthur Kiong right here on The Big Show. We continue to talk to him on The Big Show TV. Meantime, here's George Michael with Too Funky on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3.
Wow, that's quite something.
Who was the boss that called you?
Well, you know, she recruited the both of us.
I see.
You're not allowed to say? Is she still in the business? She's not.
No,
right?
But she's a sweet lady.
Okay.
Sweet lady. But you know, I mean, they all, you know, you notice this, right? Over the years, I mean, FD and myself, you did it for 2 years, Arthur. FD and myself have been doing it for close to 30 years now.
Yeah.
And we've come under many different bosses. And I can tell you this, the boss makes all the difference in the world.
True.
The boss that I think I appreciated the most was Florence Lien, because she was willing to take risks. She was willing to let the jock say whatever they wanted and take full responsibility for it.
True.
And that's what made waves. You know what I mean? Because people want to hear these things. But there are so many conservative bosses as well.
Yeah, that is true.
This is why it's so strange when I hear you tell your stories, because when Arthur was on radio, I was on Rediffusion. And our rules were different. It was no politics, no sex, no vulgarity. That was it.
Yeah.
But so everything else can.
Everything else was fine. You know, so we were very different.
But did you enjoy your 2 years as a radio DJ, Arthur?
Yes, I did. I enjoyed it tremendously. But what was at the back of my mind, really, is that, you know, one radio station is just not healthy, because there was no competition. And when there is no competition, there is really very little opportunities for one to rise up from one's career. And at that time, it was still in the day whereby you were given a morning slot or a show dependent on your academic qualifications, which was, to me, you know, one has nothing to do with the other. And when time came for a promotion at that time to a producer presenter, because one was already doing the job, one thought that one would be up for promotion. And the answer was no, you have to compete with all the new applicants that were coming in that had
qualifications.
I didn't have a degree. And so we had to compete with people with degrees. But I said, but I'm currently doing the show. They are fresh, and they says, well, you know, the thing is that then you should then be confident of yourself. You will stand a better chance since you already have job experience. I said, but it's the principle that I have to compete for the job. So the end of the story was, competed for the job, got the job, and then I decided I had to move on.
Right.
Okay. Mm. And what did you move on to then?
I moved on to become a waiter.
Okay.
So I say that facetiously, but I moved on to join a hotel school.
Yeah.
That's where I did my diploma in hospitality, and took a different turn and took a different route and left my records and headphones behind.
Wow. It was very interesting when we all heard that you'd gone into the hotel business, because we went, Arthur? Hotel business? Excuse me.
But we were also so impressed, you know. I mean, the fact that you went all the way to the top and you now lead your team, you know, as the CEO of Far East Hospitality. Mm-hmm. So, you know, at this point, I mean, we've spoken about your radio days and all that. We just want to know what's exciting that's happening right now. Far East Hospitality's expansion into wellness, spa, and resort. Tell us a little bit about.
Well, this is to take this a step a little back. We were going into Sentosa in a rather significant way. We have about we plan to have between 800 to 1,000 rooms on Sentosa. And Sentosa is a rather saturated market. So when we were going into Sentosa with around 800 to 1,000 rooms, we had to ask ourselves what was missing in Sentosa. Mm. And if you look at Sentosa, in terms of how the hotels are being composed, you'll find that about 93% of the hotels all compete in the luxury class.
Yes.
So we thought that there is an opportunity for a more differentiated hotel experience. Firstly, hotels in the mid-tier and also hotels that specializes in lifestyle niches. Mm. So that was the philosophy in going in. So we opened the Village Hotel in Sentosa a couple of years ago, pre-pandemic, and that hotel catered to families. Mm. And then we had the Outpost Hotel, and we did a rather, I thought, bold move by having the Outpost focus on just couples, no children. And then we created the Barracks Hotel. The Barracks Hotel catered to the heritage aficionados. And then to tie it all up, because it is Sentosa, we do need a wellness element, a wellness retreat. Mm. So the latest news and the biggest news that we're talking about is Oasia Resort Sentosa opens today. It's a wellness retreat, and we hope to have a wellness retreat that is different and exciting at the same time. I think it's also timely because I think post-pandemic travelers will have a much heightened level of sensitivity to health, wellness, safety. And I think a wellness retreat of the sort that we are creating in Sentosa would be relevant for the new generation of travelers that will come to Singapore.
That's interesting, because thinking of this new generation, what sort of programs, what sort of things happen at the wellness resort?
Well, I think the thing that differentiates our wellness retreat from, I suppose, everybody else's is that many hotels try to be all things to all people. Mm. And when you go to a resort, and I use the resorts in Hawaii as an example, so as not to be specific to it. Anyone, but if you take resorts in Hawaii, you stand in the lobby and you have groups of different nationalities, you have kids, you have the young people, and so it's a kind of a mix, and not everyone likes that. Mm. I think people prefer to be in an environment where others are like them. Okay. So the main selling point or the main differentiator with the Oasia Resort is that everyone there is there for wellness. So you're not going to have other market segments having to cater to. So that would allow us to be extremely focused in the way we program the resort in terms of its activities. It will be very relevant in terms of how we curate the menus.
Okay, Arthur, hold on. We're going to go back on air, okay? And we're going to talk about this once again. Nelly Furtado, Say It Right, right here on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. Our guest for this morning is an old friend. He is Mr. Arthur Kiong, CEO of Far East Hospitality. That's because back in the 80s, I mean, he was also a radio DJ. like us.
Yeah.
Yes,
but right now he is CEO of Far East Hospitality, and we're just talking to him on the Big Show TV about a very exciting thing that's happening on Sentosa. We're talking about the Oasia Resort. Please tell our radio listeners a little bit more about this fantastic resort.
Well, Oasia Resort, as you know, is the fourth hotel that is part of our ensemble of differentiated hotels to cater to different segments. The Village Hotel caters to families. The Outpost Hotel caters to couples. The Barracks Hotel caters to the heritage aficionados. And of course, you've got wellness to tie it all together. The difference with the Oasia Resort, it's fully dedicated to the wellness conscious traveler. So everything from the way we design the sleep experience right to the activities that are planned throughout the day, right to the type of treatments that are in the spa, right down to the curation of the menus, the drinks, all have wellness in mind. We try to make wellness uncomplicated, unpretentious. We try to make it pragmatic because it's, I think, you know, there's such a plethora of different trends and different diets and different, you know, fads out there. They all work if you stick to it. The difficulty is getting into a habit. So what we try to do in this particular retreat is to get like-minded people. You're in a resort where everyone is into wellness, into wanting to live a better life, and hopefully kickstart good habits that you would sustain and come back and visit us ever so often to get a refresh.
Mm. So, Arthur, you were speaking about how the menus have been curated, as well as the sleep routines and the massages and the treatments. What other activities can people look forward to when it comes to wellness at Oasia?
Well, the thing is, we think the resort experience should be outside the resort, not necessarily just stay indoors all day. So you're talking about yoga classes, you're talking water aerobics, you're talking about hikes and treks that we will plan around the island, outdoor activities, talks by experts and things that will engage you and have the days pass meaningfully and in an exciting way, rather than what a lot of people do when they go to such resorts is, you know, sit by the pool and sip a margarita, which is not terribly healthy.
Oh, that's me.
Sounds like a good idea.
Okay, we'll go back on the Big Show TV, and then I'd like to ask you about your sustainability at Oasia as well.
Yeah, because she's our green warrior. And also, Arthur, back in the day when you were doing radio, did you have any of your radio colleagues that looked like her?
None that I can think of, and I say this with great apology to those that are listening in.
Up next, Nickelback. Here's How You Remind Me on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3.
Thank you for the compliment. So, Arthur, so you know, when it comes to...
I wanted to say, if I had colleagues that looked like her, I'd be probably married three times.
So. Like some people, we know.
Shots fired.
Trying to sip his coffee.
Okay. Back to Oasia. Now, when it comes to wellness, sustainability usually goes hand in hand with that. What kind of sustainability efforts do you have going on at Oasia?
I think sustainability today is not something special that you do. Mm. And I would not venture to say that, you know, we've got a special task force that, you know, is coming up with new and exciting programs to be more sustainable than the guy next door. Mm. I think sustainability today is not only just a moral requirement, mm, but it is a corporate governance requirement. So we have to take very seriously how we reduce our carbon footprint, the type of materials we choose, and the practices that we have. And these are documented and these are submitted to the boards. And depending how many points we score, our ability to get financing is related to it. So it's not talking to, oh, we don't use straws and, you know, we try to use biodegradable product. It's a lot more comprehensive, and it's a lot more serious than what I can package in the time frame here. Mm. Mm. But I like to say that, you know, being on Sentosa, obviously wants to be carbon neutral within the next 10 years. And I think climate change is a very, very serious, in fact, I think in many ways, climate change is even more serious than the COVID pandemic, because we know that this COVID pandemic will go away at some point. Mm. But climate change, the fight has just begun. So so that's something that I think we all take very, very seriously.
Mm-hmm. Well put, well put.
Yeah.
So if someone's going to plan a staycation, what sort of tips would you have for them?
Well, I think if someone wants to plan a staycation, it would be more meaningful than having just a short 24-hour break, because, you know, I don't think you can. Sentosa deserves far more than that. Mm. I think there's a lot of. I was talking to some executives from Sentosa, and they were talking about how we can improve the mind share of Sentosa. Mm. And I shared with them, I said, I think the problem is not with mind share. The problem with Sentosa is mind shift. And why the problem is mind shift is because a lot of people think they know Sentosa and they know what to do at Sentosa. Mm. And therefore, they will do the same things that they did the last time they were there.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, if one is thinking of doing a vacation in Sentosa, especially at the Oasia retreat, one should actually give Sentosa a fresh look and look at the new attractions and the new additions and the new programs that Sentosa has on offer. And you'll find that actually one can very easily spend 3 nights in Sentosa and still find things interesting to discover. Mm. And interesting to do, because Sentosa encompasses more than just the island itself, because you have to consider the southern islands that are now incorporated into the overall offering.
Okay. And, oh, right.
And so the sailing and the exploration in the southern islands is actually quite exciting to do. So hence we think that Sentosa cater to diverse segments, and that's why we have different hotels to cater to different types. Mm-hmm. And the wellness element simply is the glue that brings everyone together, because whether you're a heritage aficionado staying at the barracks, you still want a massage that is outstanding. So there we are.
Yeah. Okay, wow. Okay.
You know what? You guys had a very, very interesting pre-launch event over the weekend, and our very own Sean Tupaz was at the Oasia Resort. And he's got a video right now that you would like to play in just a while. A photo?
Photos can. Because the videos are too special.
He did Qigong and all that.
You're making me a bit nervous, Sean, because... we weren't open yet, so...
He's like, what were you doing there when we weren't open?
Oh.
So either the service was really, really good or it was really, really bad.
Moment of truth, all right. It was very, very good. It was very, very good. I'll show you a picture of me doing Qigong first, so everybody on Facebook can see.
Wow.
So what they do, like what Arthur mentioned, they have actually like workshops.
Okay.
So yoga, HIIT workshops, Qigong as well. And this Qigong was pretty impressive because the master, or the Shifu, was very educational as well. So he taught a lot about, like, you know, where your energies come from, this and that. So I learned a lot, and it was quite fun. I had to wake up at 7 o'clock in the morning. That was the only down part.
That's okay. You wake up at 5 every day. It's fine.
That's why waking up at 7, I was like, oh, yeah, it's a Sunday. I want to sleep in. But 3 days went by very, very fast. I was there with a couple of our colleagues from ST as well.
Straight
hi, Amanda. The moment I walked into the resort, I felt healthier already. Yeah, I could really feel the health and wellness part of it hit me in the face very fast. From the smells to the, you know, the reception tea that they give you as they welcome you. Mm. It was very, very nice, yeah. And then the grill, the Bedrock Grill as well.
Mm-hmm.
So normally Bedrock Grill, I know there's one in town. And that one focused a lot on like steaks and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Here they have the steaks as well. But they made it, they had little tweaks to it to make it like with the salads and the wellness focus with your green
it's
juice.
Paleolithic, you see. It's Paleolithic.
Ah.
It's called Rock Origin.
Right.
It's like how cavemen used to eat.
Yeah,
right?
Cavemen diet.
Catch the fish fresh. They fish, fowl, and meat, and everything fresh.
Yeah, wow. Okay, it was fantastic. very fun. And I learned to do like your own body scrubs from coffee grounds and stuff like that as well.
You made body scrubs?
Yeah. So they had workshops to like make your own body scrubs.
You can turn your coffee grounds into
Arthur, he's making me want to stay there, you know. That's great. Well done, Sean.
Very, very nice.
Good job. So when people say your coffee smells great, they weren't referring to the coffee.
No.
My body, baby, my body.
Very good for cellulite treatment as well. Arthur, can you tell us a little bit more about the Oasia location in Sentosa? I have no clue where it is.
It's actually right in front of where the old Malayan used to be.
Yes.
Okay.
So it's right opposite Imbia Station.
Yes.
So it's on Siloso.
So it's right in front of Imbia Station.
Okay.
And right now they're creating a new attraction called the Discovery Walk that would connect Universal Studios all the way to Palawan Beach.
Oh,
So I can say that it's right in the center,
right,
of Sentosa, where the roundabout is.
Yeah.
Nice.
So,
okay.
So you can't miss it unless you're driving with your eyes closed.
Come, Angel, let's go for an orientation run. How about that?
Oh, and then,
okay, wait, hold on. Okay. We're going for a traffic update. Hold on.
And it will be back on air.
And then,
by 3, 2.
1FM 91.3 traffic.
We've got the usual delays across the expressways. Look out for the TPE towards the PIE. An accident after Pasir Ris Drive 8 exit. AYE towards Tuas. A vehicle broken down. This is after Lower Delta Road exit. So look out for that. That's about it for now. Please stay within the speed limit. Have everyone buckled up. Be safe as you drive today.
Good morning and welcome back to The Big Show. We are on the radio as well as on The Big Show TV. So if you're listening to us exclusively on the radio, well, you know, you've been getting a lot of Mr. Arthur Kiong. You've been watching us on The Big Show TV. You get everything.
Yeah.
That's the way The Big Show rolls. And once again, we are so, so very happy that you're with us on the show, Arthur. Mr. Arthur Kiong, of course, is the CEO of Far East Hospitality. He was once a radio DJ back in the 80s. Look where he is, look where we are.
Hey. Oh, dear.
But Arthur wasn't always a radio DJ or the CEO of hospitality. Explain this one, Arthur. I picked this one out from an old interview.
Uh-oh.
I was completely out of my element, knocking on doors of beauty salons, selling slimming products.
Oh no. Oh no.
What is
no.
this about?
Oh no. Oh, gosh.
It's amazing what stays on the internet.
it's frightening what stays on the internet. Well, the story is, after I left the army, I really didn't know what to what to do, and I stumbled upon a job selling a Japanese slimming starch, and that itself is an oxymoron.
Wow.
But
it's
you're supposed to take this starch tablet, and it will expand into your stomach, so you feel full.
Oh.
And so to sell this product, I had to canvas the hairdressing salon, because it's sold mainly to middle-aged women. And so I have to canvas hairdressing salon and knocking on doors and doing it in Mandarin and in dialect, trying to promote this Japanese product, and going to emporiums to do demonstrations with the box, and to show them how it, when you put in water, expands, and describe the scientific process with that. And after doing that for 6 months, I said to myself, you know what? This is not what I want to do. This is really not what I want to do. I don't see a career in the future in this.
Yeah.
But you know what I really want to do? My dream job would to be a stage manager at the Singapore Broadcasting Corporation. So I reached out to a lady called Lina So, who was at that time really big on radio. And I said, I'm calling you out of the blue, and I was just wanting some advice. And she was very kind. She gave me the time, and she gave me some advice on how I could apply to be a stage technician. On radio, on TV, actually.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so I came to Caldecott Hill for a test to be a stage technician. And somehow things went awry, and I ended up having to do a voice test. And I'm thinking, like, why would it be so important for a stage technician to do a voice test. I mean, how important is testing 1, 2, 3? I mean, do you have to get diction right with testing 1, 2, 3? So anyway, I did the voice test. I still remember what I read. It was, "Can you tell a story?" Can you tell the story? I still remember that. So I did the voice test, passed the voice test. And the reason I got the job was because there are not too many Chinese Singapore boys who can pronounce Thursday the 13th.
All right.
And that is the story. That's the reason, how I managed to get on the air. But it was purely because, Chinese can say Thursday the 13th.
Thursday the 13th.
So Thursday. So I could say Thursday the 13th, and that launched my career in radio.
Wow.
Great story. Amazing.
And I mean, just listening to Arthur, we can sit here and just listen to Arthur. You know what I mean? If you have it, you have it, man.
Yes, that is true. Yeah.
Arthur has always had a voice for radio. Always.
Right.
Always. Absolutely incredible.
So nice talking to you, Arthur.
Do we
have more time to talk to Arthur or not? We do
a little bit. I do have a final question, and I'd like to find out. We're talking about staycations, we're talking about wellness, sustainability, and of course about Oasia, your hotel that opens up today. I want to find out from a personal point of view what your favorite staycation routine is. We can do it on air. Arthur?
Well, my favorite staycation routine means waking up very early in the morning, and I want to get my daily swim out of the way. I do about a kilometer a day.
Wow.
And it is only possible when you have a square or a rectangle pool. Mm. It's kind of difficult to try to keep track if your pool is of a irregular shape. Mm. So I do my swim. It takes me about 25 minutes to finish that kilometer, and then after I've done that, I find it's a good time to actually continue my meditation. Now, swimming it serves three purposes. First is when you're swimming, you exercise. When you're swimming, I'm able to pray while I swim because there's no distraction. There's no distraction, so you actually it's a very, very special time to spend with the divine. And then the third reason for swimming is so that you have less time for breakfast, because I think we spend too much time eating. I try to eat only once a day. I have to decide what meal I would like to eat on that particular day. So if I eat lunch, then I would have to skip dinner. And if I have a dinner, then I obviously have to skip lunch. So time goes into that. And even during a staycation, I would work. So I would be on my mobile device. I'm one of those people that don't believe in work-life balance. I think if you want to be excellent in anything, you have to sacrifice. So work-life balance is out for me, but I do believe in work-life integration. So work is integrated in the activities I do. So I would work and then I would read. I would work and then I'll spend time with my children. I would work. And then I'll acknowledge my wife. I would work, and then I would maybe go out to do some shopping. But in between these activities, I try to keep track as to what's going on. And when there's something of significance to take care of, I'll go to a corner, order a coffee, and then dedicate an hour to compose an email or address the issue at hand. Mm. And I find that one also has to keep up with what's going on around the world. So in the evenings, usually I spend my time trying to composite through the various news channel what's going on and what has it got to do with us and how does that affects our business going forward. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the time that one is spending a vacation is to get a different perspective of how we foresee the future. Mm. And that's what I think about all the time. How what would tomorrow be? And how can we make tomorrow a better day? Mm. And the various perspectives, whether it's in an office environment, which is somewhat limited because you're only talking to the same group of people, or in a vacation where you're talking to a much greater spectrum of people and admiring the beauty of nature to remind ourselves that life is worth living. We form our impressions and our perspectives as to what decisions to make for tomorrow.
That's amazing.
Fantastic. Wow. You do all that on your vacation? Okay.
I feel so good after listening to Arthur.
I feel like I've had a vacation.
Yeah.
Nice and calm. You should do meditation apps.
I'm thinking all my vacations have been wasted.
Yeah, it's completely.
Arthur, you need to spend more time with FD, man.
Yeah. Yo. Yeah. He needs to learn how to relax. And
I have to say that FD is the only person I know that the older he gets, the better he looks.
Oh, thank you.
Don't start after, please. His head will get too big, you know.
Yeah. No, but it's really true. I mean, I knew him when he was 30, and he was
ugly. That's what he's saying.
No, actually, you know what? FD does look better now.
Yes,
than before. I've seen some of his young photos. He's just this scrawny a bit weird looking chap, you know.
Yeah.
But now he's so handsome. He looks like Richard Gere.
Yes, now he's very handsome.
Right, Arthur?
I was just actually referring to his fashion sense. I wasn't making any pokes at his physical appearance.
Oops.
It was just this red Michael Jackson beaded jacket that really got me.
Yes. Okay.
Amazing.
Ouch.
I think he wanted to be more Mick Jagger than Michael Jackson. Anyway, thank you so much, Arthur, for joining us this morning.
Pleasure is mine. It's wonderful to meet all of you, and even if it's just for half an hour, to relive my past, that was really wonderful. Thank you all.
Arthur, we've got to get together for a lunch or a dinner or drinks or something just to catch up fully.
Very happy to arrange it.
I will give you a buzz.
All right.
Okay. Fantastic. All the best.
Take care, Arthur.
Thank you. Cheers. Bye-bye.
All right. Up next, we've got Paul Young. Here's Every Time You Go Away on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3.
Jeng's coming in.
That's just amazing.
But you know, I mean, you can tell he was a radio DJ back in the 1980s.
Oh, yeah.
Because all of them sounded like that. You could listen to them for hours.
Very calming voices.
They've got that very calm voice. Yeah.
Arthur, Jeanette Joseph.
That baritone.
Yeah. Lynn Sardone. You know, they all have that wonderful
We've got people on our Facebook page who are remembering the shows that these ladies hosted.
Mm. Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah.
Morning, Johan.
Good morning, Johan.
Morning, Johan.
Happy Wednesday.
Happy Wednesday. Wednesday.
How are you? Looking very sharp this morning?
Yeah.
Really?
No, no.
With the feed.
How's everybody?
Good. Everybody's good.
Very now that
good
you're today. Here, we're in the mood to sing along with you, man.
Yeah.
So today, can you do a classic today? Because we've got a lot of classic listeners today.
Yeah, a lot of people.
You mean all?
No, not all.
Just sorry.
John is the youngest.
We are not
even
the
youngest. No, I'm not the youngest.
Yeah.
Sean is.
Oh no, Shalini is the youngest.
Yeah.
Shalini, Sean, then me.
No.
You're 20 something, right?
No, I'm not.
Right? No, he's not. He's in his 30s for sure.
No, la.
30 what?
John is like 25, la. Come on.
Yeah, that's why I thought 29.
1986.
I'm 87.
87. Okay, so he is older. Right.
Just missed.
1 year.
Just missed out.
All these babies, my God. 86.
Millennials.
Like, what
millennials.
Was I doing in 86?
I was already working when you were born.
Oh, 86. I remember 86. 86, I was French kissing this girl.
Oh, my God.
Really? What?
You know, East Coast.
Just,
you know, near McDonald's and all that.
Yes.
Under this shed,
tree?
Right?
Oh, shed.
Yeah. And then someone from behind shouted, "Oi, free show!" Okay, was that 87?
No, I must pay money.
How old were you then?
I was...
Like
20? I was...
Younger.
No!
Oh, younger.
86, I was 16.
16. Yeah. Oh, 16?
Yeah, school. Just
16.
Yeah.
You know
the secondary four St. Pat's boys?
Yeah.
Kissing the Katong Convent girls.
Katong Convent, right? Where would they have been from?
Hey, 5 years old, I was already kissing a girl on the lips already.
You mean your mom?
In kindergarten.
Started young.
Wow. Okay.
Wow.
Okay,
anyway.
All right, music time. We'll do Nostalgia Wednesday another day.
Okay, so times of your life.
Oops.
Paul Anker. Is that what we're doing?
Wow.
No. He has prepared.
Yeah.
What?
Give him a chance. He's like, what song is that?
He's lost.
We can guess the song that you're doing. Which year? Since we have a bit of time.
1986.
86, I think.
Oh, are you really? Serious?
It was last year's number 215.
Oh! Oh. Okay, I know this one.
Come on.
You play a bit, like him here.
1986. Play a rift or something.
Hootie and the Blowfish!
I don't think they were born then.
Well, this is a harder game than Guess the Lyrics.
There's a lot of sauce with this course, man.
Can you just sing it? Can you
yeah, that's
sing
it? Everybody.
John Lennon, Imagine.
Yeah. That was number 700.
Clue, give a bill.
Sometimes I wonder I'll ever make it through.
Firehouse, is it?
Through this world without having you. I just wouldn't have a clue.
Everybody googling.
Sometimes it seems like this world's closing in on me, and that's the way of breaking free. And then I see you reach for me. Sometimes I wanna give up, I wanna give in, I wanna quit the fight. And then I see you, baby, and everything's alright. Everything's alright. When I see you smile, I can face the world. Oh, you know I can do anything. When I see you smile, I see a ray of light. Oh, I see you shine bright.
Oh, I've become orange.
When I see you smile, baby.
Oh my goodness, worse now.
Baby, when I see you smile at me.
So orange.
He's in a tanning room.
Baby, there's nothing this world could ever do.
Hey, he looks good, man.
Touch of your hair can do. It's like nothing that I ever knew. Yeah, and when the rain is falling, I don't feel it. It's here with me now, and why look at you, baby? It's all I ever need. It's all I ever need. When I see you smile, I can face the world. Oh. When I see you smile,
smiles.
Good thing it's not your card.
When I see you smile, baby, when I see you smile at me,
something I'm the one
to give up. I wanna give it. I wanna quick with the bye. The one look at you, baby, and everything's alright. Everything's alright. Alright. When I see you smiles, I can face the world. Oh, you know I can do anything. When I see you smile,
when I see you smile,
baby, when I see you smile,
is that bad English?
Bad English.
At me.
1989.
Congrats, CH Coco, for getting the song right.
How did you like that? When I see you smiles. That's
brought to you by Esso.
That's kind of bad English, right?
But brought to you by Esso.
Hey, you know what? Esso sponsors the Kiss 92 breakfast show. No, maybe they should just cut the sponsorship and come and sponsor us.
Come to us.
Because I mean, I just gave
you
guys
smiles.
Yeah, you know. And then, you know, We can sing that song all the time.
That can be true. Our theme song. Yeah. The bad English
our opening
song.
Smiles.
I'm going to go back on air and see that again.
When I see you smiles.
When I see you smiles.
And this segment is brought to you by Esso.
See
how it works?
Yes.
See how it works?
Yeah. It works well.
Oh, it rings.
Yeah.
Oh. Morning, everybody. Morning, Clement.
I hope.
Anyways, today is Frida's birthday, right?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
But we're going back on air first.
Yes, happy birthday, Frida.
We're going to go back on air.
Frida.
My cat's birthday as well. It just turned one
today. Good morning, cat.
Oh, wow.
Hey, what's your cat's name again? Sorry, keep on forgetting.
Mochi.
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 Happy birthday, Mochi.
All right, stand by. We're going back on air.
Meow.
Every day on traffic and then on air.
Yeah.
In 3, 2.
1FM 91.3 traffic.
Usual delays across the expressways, TPE towards the PIE, an accident after Pasir Ris Drive, 8 exit AYE towards Tuas, a vehicle broken down after Lower Delta Road exit. That's about it for now. Just a bit of patience if you're on the expressways, please. Stay within the speed limit, have everyone buckled up, be safe as you drive today.
Good morning, Singapore. Good morning, Singapore. So we were singing off air.
We were
singing on the Big Show TV with Johan Lee.
When I see you smiles.
When I see you smiles. Get on the Big Show TV. We'll explain to you
you'll,
why.
You'll understand. Yeah.
I said that.
Yeah.
But you know, a big thank you once again to Mr. Arthur Kiong for joining us earlier on. You know what an awesome session we had with him, and you know, Johan.
Yeah.
Just because, you know, some people are just listening to us on the radio. They're not watching us on the Big Show TV at this point.
Mm.
But you sing exclusively for us on the Big Show TV. So you did one song. You're going to be doing another two or three songs. What's the next song that's coming up? So that people can, you know, now go to their devices and switch you on the Big Show TV and then drive or ride their bike while watching you at the same time.
Hey, What bike? You mean bicycle or bike?
No.
Motorbike?
Motorbike.
Either or, no.
No, they're listening. They're listening, yeah.
Can be done.
No.
No, they can have it on as long as they listen and not watch.
It's distractive, though, if you're going to have it on.
It depends, la. I mean, if it's Friday, then it'll be a bit hard because it's, you know, Makan Sutra Friday.
It's very visual, right?
Yeah. But you know, yesterday I was on Facebook, right? And you know, on Facebook they have this traffic vigilante or SG vigilante.
Yes.
I can't remember what it's called, but usually it's incidences, right, on the road through the what do you call the camera?
The dash cam.
And now they've got, like, you know, cameras behind as well.
Yes.
So very interesting videos, and then people coming out and they're, you know, road all raging and all that.
Yeah.
And there was this one video, right? OneFM was playing in the background.
Thanks for the publicity. Was it the Big Show?
I don't know, but definitely it was us.
Okay,
it was OneFM. You see,
probably something you said.
Yeah, so which is why I'm pushing now. You know, for people who are driving or riding their bikes and all that, to either listen to us or watch us on the Big Show TV.
I think just listen to us would be a good idea.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
safe idea.
Yeah,
okay.
Don't listen
fantastic.
To Glenn, yeah.
Fantastic.
All right.
Amazing.
Okay.
Johan is going to do the next song, and this next song is going to be one of my nominations for the Greatest Hits of All Time Countdown 2021.
Mm. Okay.
How do you know?
I know, bro.
No, he's nominating it to be on the list.
Okay, for those of you who want to know what this song is, you got to watch us on the Big Show TV, okay? In the meantime, here's Modern Talking. Atlantis is calling song number 810 last year on the Greatest Hits of All Time Countdown. Good morning, Singapore.
He's full of nonsense.
Okay, we also want to say happy birthday to the Secretary General of Administration of the Big Show TV unofficial Facebook page, fan page.
Yes.
Frida, it's your birthday today.
Happy birthday, Frida.
Happy birthday to Isabel Frida.
Happy birthday to you.
And many more. Is one of the coolest people.
Yeah, she is. Frida's awesome.
All right, what song do you have? Oh gosh, it's very loud. So, what song do you have for us, Johan?
So she requested for this one something by Stereophonics.
Yep.
Wow. She requested for it.
Mm.
Oh, yes. Nice. Okay.
Haven't heard this in ages, man. This Stereophonics song.
It's called "Have a Nice Day."
Mm. Have a nice day.
Ready?
Yeah, we think so.
I'm nominating.
San Francisco Bay, past by 39, early PM, can't remember what time. Got the waiting cab, stop at the red light. I'm just sure I'm but it turned out just right. He started straight up coming, here is hell. That's his first word, we asked what it meant. Said where you're from, they told him out loud. Take a holiday, it's just what you want. So have a nice day. Have a nice day. Lie around all day, half a dream of cheese. The seven tourists, yeah, that's what I hate. Seven going wrong, we'll all become the same. Dress the same, it's only our accents change. So have a nice day, and 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 have a nice day.
Have a nice day and smile. Frida says, thank you very much for playing the song for me. She says, everybody needs a nice day.
Oh, so sweet.
Are we all having a nice day?
We are having an amazing day. Wednesday means two more sleeps to the weekend.
Actually, really, time flies.
It does.
I mean, it's true. Time flies when you're having fun, right?
Yes.
Really, the weeks are just going by so very quickly.
Christmas tree going up soon.
It's scary. Oh, wow.
It's very scary.
Pumpkin.
Why don't you just put up your Christmas tree?
Oh, yeah. It's only September, though.
Then people can laugh at you.
You see, everyone who has, fake Christmas trees, right? Mm-hmm. You know, should just put their Christmas trees up right now.
Yeah, I've got a fake Christmas tree.
Yeah.
It's very beautiful.
Yeah.
Maybe I should just put it up. It's fairly big. I put it up and put like one ornament per day.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and lead up until Christmas.
Yeah.
And it'll be there until February.
You know the reason why I get like real Christmas trees at the end of the year? Because I don't want to store the fake Christmas tree. Because growing up, right? Yeah. We always had that box that we put in the storeroom, right? And it always feels good when you have a big Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Right? So the fake Christmas tree takes up so much space in that box.
Yeah. Mine is okay. Mine is not bad.
I never experienced that growing up.
What do you mean?
Fake Christmas tree and putting it in a box.
Real.
No. We used to go out and find tree branches.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Right? Then we would take spray snow. Mm-hmm.
And spray it white.
Spray the tree.
Yeah.
Then we would hang cotton wool off the tree.
Okay.
To make it look like snow. And then decorate the tree.
Oh, cute. So it's just branches.
It was just branches done with snow spray and cotton wool.
That's beautiful, though.
And then we would...
And lights and stuff.
And we put all the decorations.
Yeah,
it sounds quite
like
nice.
A branch.
It
was really cool.
But that green is like...
so you cool. have no vision.
But special. I mean, it was special.
Yeah, it's special, yeah.
And we always did that. We always did that. How my father never got into trouble for chopping off branches...
Oh, he would chop up. I thought you would be picking these up
plus
from fallen trees.
No,
that's right.
No, so we were rich.
Why are you doing cheapskate?
He had people chop the branches for him.
No, my father used to go.
Yeah, like the biggest house, you know, staying in the biggest house on Cane Hill, you know, and then, you know, he goes and chops other people's trees
right?
down.
And use branches.
Cannot grow his own tree, right?
That's why.
Oh, my goodness.
Have you got pictures of this?
I have at home.
Oh, do you?
Printed ones.
Really?
Yeah, I must go and find them.
Take a photo of it. Don't bring them in.
I cannot imagine it.
So anyway, now I think the trend is to get a real Christmas tree, right? Yeah. So the noble firs and all that. So that's what I get. Because at the end, we just throw it away. We just come and get someone to collect the tree.
Yeah. What do they actually do with those trees when it's done? I wonder.
Firewood?
I think they chop for which country?
Huh?
They don't like chop it.
Our pizzerias here in Singapore, they have...
Rubbish. You know, what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do a story on this on Green Monday because I'd be keen to find out what they do and how many trees they chop just for that.
Okay, so the place that you buy the trees from, you give them a call, they will come and pick up your tree,
right?
Okay,
but what do they do with it after?
And then they'll just leave it out under the sun, just dry them up.
And then
they'll distribute it to the pizzerias here in Singapore. ovens.
Or do they chop it up and then let it sort of compost down?
I don't know. Yeah. But I'll look it up.
Yeah that'd be very interesting.
I know that real Christmas trees create such a mess, though, when the pine starts falling and stuff like that,
okay,
right?
Just sweep it now.
No, but the advantage of the real Christmas tree
is the smell.
I have candles for that.
What? So,
I got pine candles.
The same thing.
No, of course, yes. Okay. Thank you, Sean.
Going back on air.
Okay.
Viewers, and then I will come back and then you can sing one last poem.
Camila Cabello
right here on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. We're just having this really awesome conversation about Christmas trees.
Because it's September.
Yeah, and what happens to these real Christmas trees after
Christmas? Yeah, if you know the answer, please WhatsApp us or write on our Facebook page or something. Yeah. Drop it in our chat. Our WhatsApp number is 8855-0913. We want to know what happens to Christmas trees after Christmas.
Yeah, and actually, I already gave them the reason, but they don't believe me.
I like your reason.
The wood goes to the pizzerias.
Makes sense.
There aren't enough pizzerias in Singapore to cater for that wood.
Because everyone wants to save, gas and electricity and all that. So they're using firewood.
Wood fire ovens. Right.
Yes, wood fire ovens.
And in the fireplaces as well, right? Maybe? No?
No fireplace. Okay, Angel, right. You're being silly.
That's why I'm judging.
Meanwhile, Johan is sitting there going, when am I going to sing?
He's going to sing when we go back on the
Where is this going?
Okay, so this always comes back to the greatest hits of all time countdown here on 1FM 91.3, okay? The 2021 version of the greatest hits of all time countdown. Because actually, tell the truth, after last year, I thought this year we wouldn't be doing the greatest hits of all time countdown already. But our music director, Charmaine Poir, had all these requests from our 1FM listeners, our 1FM fans, asking for their favorite hits to be featured this year on the countdown once again. So how can we say no to
We can't say no to 1FM our listeners.
You can't.
So nominations are now open, okay? Till the 8th of September. Mm-hmm. So you have
1 week.
All right. So if you would like to submit your nominations, okay, all you need to do is just go to 1fm.sg/913greatest hits. So what Johan just did, Have a Nice Day by Stereophonics, that was my nomination.
Okay. And you're going to play another greatest hits when we go back on The Big Show TV.
In the meantime, let's get ready because our people at the newsroom, I do believe, Adrian.
Yes.
Adrian is on standby right now, ready to go with headline news and sports.
I'm waving to Adrian.
Newsroom.
Last song.
This is Angel's nomination.
Sure.
This next song that
you're going to nominate. Better be good. You can nominate as many songs as you want.
Talking about trees.
It's a tree song.
Neon trees.
Lemon tree.
Lemon tree.
There are not many songs about trees.
Tree. I'm sitting here in a boring room. It's just another rainy sunny afternoon. I'm wasting my time. I got nothing to do. I'm hanging around. I'm waiting for you. But nothing ever happens. And I wonder. I'm driving around in my car. I'm driving too fast, I'm driving too far. I like to change my point of view. I feel so lonely, I'm waiting for you. But nothing ever happens. And I wonder. I wonder how, I wonder why. Yesterday you told me about the blue sky. And all that I can see is just a yellow
lemon tree.
This was such an abeng song when it came out.
I'm turning my head up and down. I'm turning.
Case in point.
Turning around. And all that I can see is just a yellow lemon tree.
Inquisitive.
Da 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 da. Da 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 da
Came on our Facebook page and went, yeah, Ubbing Times, the best.
Right, see, I told you this is such an Ubbing song.
But don't play the fool. I tell you, the Ubbing songs do very well.
Hey,
huh?
They do. Yeah.
Although
they
that song do. Was song 420 last year.
One
on
hit
the
wonder,
countdown.
Right? Was it a one hit wonder? It was.
Yes, it was a one hit wonder.
One hit wonder.
It
was,
how is it an Ubbing song? I can't imagine.
No, it's an Ubbing song.
It's like,
all the Ubbing
wonder.
No, then they come to that chorus. That's all they knew.
The guy that sang Lemon Tree was colorblind as well.
I'm sure there are different remixes, right, for that song.
Ooh, I got a good one.
Sure. Right? Do you?
By Inquisitive. It's a DJ version, like a techno version.
Inquisitive.
Of Lemon Tree, right?
Lemon Tree. The local DJ Inquisitive?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
And that's why
local
it's,
DJ. He's a local
that's why
DJ,
it's
yeah.
Ubbing, you see, you know what yeah. I mean? Yeah. Are you
going
to play it?
Are you
going to
play?
No, Lando.
Oh, okay.
But I just want to once again mention the greatest hits of all time countdown. For those of you who don't know, this year we are capping it at 2,000 nominated songs only.
Yes.
So I think it's almost there. We're almost there. But you can still get your nominations in. And you'll stand to win a $100 Alfero Gelato dining voucher.
Just for nominating.
Just
yeah?
for nominating.
Just for nominating. Yeah, you know? Then will come the votes later.
Yeah, so go to onefm.sg/913 greatest hits. Okay.
All right.
Julio's.
All right. Thank
Time
you very
to
much,
say goodbye.
Johan.
Thanks, thank you very much.
Thanks, Johan.
All right. We all
thank
sign
you.
Off together.
Okay. All right. Okay. Share the video.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.